Good morning to all of you. Welcome to today's class. The last class we had stopped at the features of APC, right? Today we are going to talk about the marginal propensity to consume, MPC. Write down the definition. It refers to the ratio between change in consumption within the brackets delta C to change in income delta Y. MPC is the ratio of change in consumption, expenditure, delta C, to change in income, and MPC will be calculated as MPC, which is small b here, equals to delta C upon delta Y. The value of MPC will always lie between 0 and 1. The value of MPC always lies between 0 and 1. So what I have written, MPC always lies between 0 and 1. 0 less than MPC less than 1. The value of MPC will always be between 0 and 1. Now we will take a schedule to explain this. So, first column I have income, which is Y. Then we have consumption. Consumption, which is, I'm writing this part of the book, consumption, which is C. Third, we'll have change in income, that is delta Y. And next, we'll have delta C or change in consumption. And MPC, what is MPC? It is delta C upon delta Y, change in consumption upon change in income. Income, let us start from 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. Consumption, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. Now, what is delta Y change? The first delta will change from 15 to 20, it becomes 5. 20 to 25, again 5. 25 to 30, again 5. 30 to 35, 5. This is change in income. Change in consumption. Change in consumption, What is the change in consumption? Change in income is here is all. Looking at the wrong one. Change in income, this is the first. 10, this is 10, this is 10. Change in consumption. 5, 5, 5, 5. Sorry, I was in the wrong column. Okay, now delta C upon delta Y 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. That is change in consumption upon change in income. 5 upon 10, 0.5, 5 upon 10, 0.5, true. Now write down the features of MPC based on this schedule. Features of MPC. First, the value of MPC always lies between 0 and 1. You see, it will always lie between 0 and 1. MPC is assumed to be positive and less than unity which means that when income increases, the whole of it is not spent on consumption. The whole of it is not spent on consumption. On the other hand, when income falls, consumption expenditure does not decline in the same proportion and never becomes zero. Second, if entire additional income within brackets delta Y is consumed MPC equals 1, third point, if entire additional income delta Y is saved, then change in consumption is zero. In such a situation, MPC equals zero. Fourth point, if MPC is low, sorry, not if, the MPC is low, in the case of rich people, and high in the case of the poor. And the last point, MPC of underdeveloped or developing countries is high than developed countries. These are the features of MPC. Why do we say the MPC is low in case of the rich people and high in the case of the poor? Anyone who would want to answer this question? Why is the MPC low in the case of rich people and high in the case of the poor? It's simply because the level of income varies. You see, a poor person's income is low. When your income is low, what happens? You tend to satisfy all your needs by spending all your income, isn't it? There is no room for saving. There is no room for saving. So the little limited income that you have, all that income is spent on your consumption. That is why MPC is high in the case of the poor. But in the case of the rich people, the level of income is high, and because the level of income is high, the MPC, that is the marginal proportionate to consume, is relatively lesser than the income which they are earning. The income is high, they are also consuming, but it is so high the income that the MPC is less as compared to a poor person. Poor persons, absolute or the total income gets normally spent for consumption. That is the reason. Now, next topic, difference between APC and MPC. Difference between APC and MPC. Average propensity to consume and marginal propensity to consume. Difference. We will do it in a columnar method. Okay. First APC, second MPC. Columnar method. First point, meaning. For APC, you write, it is the ratio between total consumption within brackets C and total income within brackets Y at a given level of income of the economy. MPC refers to the ratio between change in consumption within brackets delta C to the change in income within brackets delta Y. Second point, value. The value of APC can be greater than 1 when consumption expenditure becomes greater than income, becomes greater than income. On the other side, the value of MPC always lies between 0 and 1. The value of MPC always lies between 0 and 1. Third point of difference. When income increases, this is an APC. When income increases, APC falls. But at a less rate than MPC. On the other side, MPC, when income increases, MPC falls, but more rapidly than APC. Fourth point. The formula for APC is APC is equal to C upon Y. APC equals C upon Y. And the formula for MPC is equal to delta C upon delta Y. Delta C upon delta Y. We'll stop till here. Tomorrow we will do the saving function. Okay, we will stop.